What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to set up and use the new Folia plugin server type. Customizing your vanilla Minecraft server can take many forms, with paper or spigot being popular choices. But as you add on more and more, it can lead to some performance issues in the game. Luckily, there's a new server type that introduces a wide variety of improvements to make everyone's gameplay experience better. This is known as Folia, a fork of paper that is slowly becoming the go-to for hosting plugin servers. Whether you're wanting quicker startup times or chunk rendering, Folia can help solve all of your performance issues. There's a lot of questions from server owners regarding the new server type, such as its differences and the benefits compared to alternative choices. We'll start off by saying that Folia implements multi-threading for dedicated servers, allowing you and others to enjoy extremely fast loading times, among other aspects. This means large servers with over 100 players can easily enjoy the benefits with no lag or other problems. If you're curious about the other specifics of Folia, then you can also review their official page for more information. We do also want to note that at the time of writing, Folia is in experimental mode. This means that some builds can be unstable or have unforeseen problems that the developers will resolve later on. Because of this, we recommend backing up any of your worlds or server files to be completely safe. To install Folia onto the server, head towards your Apex server panel and scroll down to find the game file section. After that, click on the currently selected option to reveal the drop-down menu, and then you can type in Folia in the text box and press on it once found. Press understood due to Folia being experimental, and then you can click create new world and restart now in the following prompts. Like I said earlier, Folia implements multi-threading for dedicated Minecraft servers. This is extremely useful since now regions have their own main thread for ticks in game that happens for every chunk. In other words, you and other players will likely retain a perfect 20 ticks per second in most cases. Additionally, Folia introduces a quicker restart and startup response time due to these changes. On the other hand, Folia does come with some limitations. This is mainly noticed by the lack of plugins for it, since the design is incompatible with the majority of add-ons. Sadly, another problem is the lack of a specific config file for Folia, meaning you're only able to tweak spigot, bucket, or paper documents in the FTP panel. This might change as Folia is developed and updated, but for the time being, you're pretty limited. As for the gameplay itself, it's pretty much going to feel like any other Minecraft server, but whether you're wanting some plugins or none at all, everything will feel a lot smoother. The amount of response time for both the server and in-game aspects is extremely noticeable. This is amplified if you're comparing breaking blocks with Folia and paper, since it's almost instantaneous with multi-threading. If you're curious about what plugins are available for Folia, then we have a list for you here. Remember that these ones have been tested and they for sure work, but more may be compatible depending on their design. Of course, as Folia continues to develop, you can expect more and more plugins to show up on this compatibility list. Once you have your plugins you want to add, the process is the same for any other server type, so make sure to review our guide linked down below. As for configuration, Folia doesn't offer any specific configuration file to tweak, but there are plenty of other ones to edit. These include spigot, paper, and bucket documents, containing useful options to personalize your gameplay experience. Alternatively, you can run the JFR start-stop command with operator privileges to receive backend information to help you resolve in-game problems. Head to the FTP file access in the top left corner of the main panel, log in, and then find your desired file in the list and press edit to the far right. Note that the config directory is where paper options will be for you to tweak. Continue to make any changes and then click save at the top, and then you can return to the main panel and restart the server to apply any of the edits. If your server isn't starting, it's most likely going to be previously installed plugins that don't work with Folia. Remember that for the time being, most add-ons won't work with this server type, so you might need to remove any old plugins and make sure only tested ones are used. Folia still has a long way to go, but its groundbreaking implementations prove that it will eventually become a big name in the bucket-based server game. Until then, all we can do is support, so be sure to check out Folia and see how much it can help you. That's all for this one, and as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all of our future videos.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.